What's up, guys? Coach Nate here from The Run Experience, asking the question, is the run, walk, run method popularized by Jeff Galway a good idea for runners? If it is a good idea, in what context should we be using it? And of course, are there times where we're overusing it, we're over relying upon it, and we get stuck in a little bit of a rut using it too? So that's what we're gonna talk about today. Stick around, let's dig in. So the run, walk, run method, popularized by Olympian Jeff Galway, is a predetermined set of run and walk intervals that you would either use just for your daily or weekly runs, or actually while training for an event, or in the actual race itself. And an example might be, you're gonna run for 5 minutes, and you're gonna walk for 1 minute, no matter what, and you're gonna break your whole run the whole way, and you're gonna start even when you're fresh. You're not waiting till you're absolutely tired and exhausted, you're starting those walk breaks super early. Another example could be distance, where you're running a mile, walking 30 seconds afterwards, running another mile, and so on and so forth all the way through. It's something that's been pretty popularly used by beginner to intermediate runners, as it makes running a little bit more accessible. We'll talk about that in a second. But I also want to note that ultra runners use this method all the time. I've yet to meet the 100-mile elite ultra runner who doesn't walk at all during the whole thing. And in fact, sometimes terrain dictates what's happening. If I'm going up a really steep hill, I'm gonna hike that thing as opposed to run it. So we can start to see this show up in different places. In my former life as a triathlete, I know a lot of very fast elite Ironman athletes who were doing their marathon in the heat of the day in the afternoon. By the time they got off that really long swim and that really long bike ride, that they would purposely slow down and stop in the aid stations to get a little bit more food and fluid. So in essence, they were on that run a mile, get a little food and fluid, run a mile, get a little food and fluid, and walk. So we can start to see that this run, walk, run method expands way beyond just the beginner to intermediate runner, and it has a lot of applications. The next thing we're going to talk about, really the benefits of those things and how you can use this best for yourself. So what is it about these walk breaks that makes such a difference? Well, I remember listening to Jeff Galway speak one time, and he was talking about training some of his runners to get up to that 18 to 20 mile long run for the marathon. And he found when he was able to implement strategic walk breaks throughout, his runners were not as sore after. And it really got me thinking, why were they not as sore even though they did the same distance? They did just as much pounding as everyone else, but their bodies felt a little bit better. And it got me thinking on some other areas that I do know. We could say, well, maybe they got these moments where they just lowered the intensity a little bit and the heart rate got to drop down, they got to recollect themselves a little bit. But I also realized, I was like, oh, this is a huge mechanical reset. I know that in the gym, it's a very different flavor if I were to do, say, 5 deadlifts every minute for 20 minutes, where I would get lots of rest in between those sets of 5 deadlifts, versus trying to do 100 deadlifts in a row. If I try to do 100 deadlifts in a row, there's gonna be a moment where I just can't maintain my form anymore and I'm gonna start to break down. And at that 90th to 100th one, I'm gonna be hobbling around a little bit more. Whereas if I have those breaks periodically in, I could string together shorter doses of higher quality movement. And I was like, huh, this is probably what's happening with this run, walk, run method. Runners are degrading when they push themselves, their form starts to fall apart, and they start to deal with a lot of pounding and soreness as a result. Whereas if I put those walk breaks in there, it allows me to string together shorter doses of higher quality run mechanics so that I finish doing the same distance, but not feeling as sore. And I'm like, huh, that's pretty darn cool. And as I just gave an example, we use this in the gym and other forms all the time. Now, some other interesting, helpful things about this. For nutrition, for those of you guys who have trouble eating and drinking with your jostling stomach in those long runs, giving yourselves those walk breaks gives you that opportunity to get those food and fluids in a little bit more easily. Super important when you're on those longer duration events, and also when it's hotter, because when it's hotter, I've got less blood around the small intestine. It's out into my arms and legs to try to keep myself a little bit cooler. And that makes it harder to digest, right? And then of course, it makes running just more accessible to the beginner and the intermediate athlete. You know, for some of you guys, you may have forgotten this, but there was a moment when running 10 minutes, 20 minutes, 30 minutes was just murder because you were either walking or you were at sprinting zone 5 or whatever, right? So there was nothing in between because you just hadn't run that much yet. So for athletes who are just getting into running, adding these walk breaks in there allowed them to wrap their head around that 30-minute run and extend it a little bit further and, hey, not feel as beat up either. Now, unfortunately, there are some downsides to this, especially if we don't apply this strategy in the right place or we get too reliant upon it. That's what we're going to talk about next. So ultimately, the run, walk, run method is a powerful tool that all runners can and should be using for various purposes or situations. It really shines the brightest over those longer distances, those hotter days, and those steeper climbs, as we talked about. And that's why we've seen a lot of people use it in ultra marathons. We've seen people use it in Ironman distance races, getting through aid stations. And of course, people have set new PRs in the half marathon, the marathon distance, and even qualify for the Boston Marathon. But it's perhaps not as appropriate for shorter distance events, especially if I'm a competitive runner. I want to build that strength, my ability to maintain my ability to run all the way through that entire 10K or a little bit faster. If I'm using this to hide from mobility issues, my knee hurts all the time, well, I better be addressing why that knee is really hurting in the first place. And perhaps the run, walk, run method is part of my strategy to get out of that funk, but that's not the first and only thing I want to turn to. And then finally, hey, if I'm within a mile of that finish line and in sight, I'm probably not going to hit my little walk break right there. I'm going to probably try to muscle my way all the way through so I can have that strong finish. Man, I was just about to start saying something and then it left, just how things do sometimes. I think I need more coffee. Not right. I'm thinking right now. And it really is this downside. What? What am I saying? Is this a little bit better? Hey, if you are serious about getting better as a runner and addressing some of those deficiencies in your strength and in your run technique and really putting it all together, well, I invite you to join us 2 weeks for free in our Quick Start program. We even have different tracks depending on the type of runner you are, if you are dealing with an injury, if you are training for a race, or you're a new runner just looking to get fit for the first time. All you need to do is click the link below in the video or in the little card of this video itself. And you can get access to that 2 week Quick Start program. Of course, if you like this video, guys, give us that old thumbs up, hit that like button. If you have any comments or questions about what we talked about today, you defenders of the run walk method, you people who've never tried it before, let's have a conversation. And of course, subscribe to our channel, guys. We got new videos coming out each and every week. We want you to see them, and we're gonna keep filming. We're gonna get a tan. It's gonna be good. I'll see you guys in the next one.